So, welcome back to another video of mine. This time I wanted to talk to you guys about different shows that I used to watch when growing up in the 90s and everything. And we'll start off with Are You Afraid of the Dark? It's one of my favorite shows that kind of scared me growing up. The different stories that they were there. I'm gonna let you know, not all these shows that I have watched in the 90s are on this list. I decided to look it up. A bunch of shows. But yeah, Are You Afraid of the Dark? Gave me the creeps. I loved it. Cat Dog. My husband actually bought this DVD set, I believe. And it's somewhere in our apartment. But yeah, I always loved it. I always liked Dog more. But, of course, the biggest question is, if one ate, where does the poop go out of, you know? Dracula. I never actually watched this show. I remember seeing things on it, but never really saw it myself. This is Cousin Skeeter. I love this show. If you don't know, this character right here was voiced by Lil Bow Wow. If I remember correctly. But yeah, one of my favorite shows out there. Double Dare. Game show that I loved. I know there was a video I did a while ago that, not too long ago, where I talked about game shows, and I never actually thought of Nickelodeon game shows. But yeah, Double Dare, loved it. There was one time when my family and I went to Nickelodeon Studios, and my sister and I both participated in Double Dare on it. Doug, love the show. One of the weirdest ones out there, I would say, especially with indicating on different characters having different skin colors and all that. And some of them I thought were sick of some sort. Okay, Franklin. One of the shows to where it's definitely younger, my crowd, but I would occasionally watch it nonetheless. It was sometimes educational, if I remember correctly, but very entertaining. Galaga Island. Okay, craziest thing about it, it had a giant toad that kids played around with and all that. I think, thinking about it now, is it probably some sort of, Godzilla type of situation, radioactive frog or something like that, and I really enjoyed it. I think it was in Hawaii, don't remember, but one thing that made me question sleepovers is when both boys and girls had a bunch of people, like their friends, sleeping over at the same time. I was like, wow, I never thought of boys having friends over to sleep over, same time as girls in a family. Hey Arnold. They're actually coming out with a movie with this, from what I hear. I don't know if it's later this year or what, but it's going to be pretty interesting when they do. I always loved it, and like this character always thought called him a football head. I'm like, and she loved him. They had a huge crush on him and everything. Like, okay, that's one way to show your love, by being a bully to the character. Jim Henson's Animal Show. I have actually never saw this show. If I did, I don't remember. If anyone watching this, let me know if you've seen the show or not. And tell me if I could get it on Amazon or eBay or something like that. I would like to actually watch it because I'm a big Jim Henson fan. God blam! Okay. There's some show on Nickelodeon, but Cartoon Network that has a similar setup that's like this, I would say. But yeah, this is really fun, a show that I loved watching, even reruns of it. I'm like, still watch it anyways. Kenan and Kel, love the show. It's a spinoff from All That. And Kenan actually is now an SNL member. And I love the show. If you've seen the show, you know what I get. You'll get it when I say, who loves orange juice? I do. Legends of the Hidden Temple. There was like a movie that just recently came out, or this year, or later that it will be coming out later this year, that's on Legend of this character or anything. And it's a type of racing type of game, puzzle achievements. I always wanted to be on the show and to be one of the contestants. I thought it was a fun game. I always got excited when it came on. And I honestly wish I could be on the show. I wish there was more shows like this in particular, and it lasted a lot longer than it did. Adventures of Pete and Pete. I love the show. It was like two brothers, both named Pete, and the younger brother, he actually voiced Jimmy on Grand Theft Auto 5. I thought it was so weird. But yeah, and I think the artist also created Jimmy in the likes of the younger Pete. Eureka's Castle. I vaguely remember the show, because I remember this, the chick in the middle with the horns. I really liked it. I wanted a character exactly like it. And same with the bat. Awesome looking characters, in my opinion. You're on another game show. Not too familiar with it. I believe I have watched it, but it was so long ago, I don't remember. Blue's Clues. Yes. I used to watch Blue's Clues. I stopped watching it shortly before Joe was the new person showing, doing Blue's Clues and everything. So it was like there was a season there that I didn't watch, and then next season was Joe. So I started watching the shows again, seeing how that guy did, and for me personally, it wasn't the same, but it was overall definitely a little kid show. I still watch it once in a while. Shoot, last year or a year before, I watched it, an episode, or at least part. Real Monsters. Loved it. Saw the where they did this at Nickelodeon also. I thought it was so awesome. I couldn't choose between which character was my favorite at all. All of that. Every time I tell people about this show, I always consider it the kids' version of Saturday Night Live. Okay? I loved it. It was like 5 or 6 seasons. Pretty much watched all of them. I loved every single one of these episodes of the show. Always did great comedy. Andy and Dexter. I didn't watch too much of this, but I rather did enjoy it. I see in the still picture, that's the type of style they did. It was like two short people, and those are actual paints. So it's like there's toes of a person's hand and everything. And they did various drawings and stories and everything. Didn't know too many people that watched this at all. Animorphs. Seen a few episodes, read more books of it, loved it all. They were pretty good at getting what went from paper to screen. And I don't own any of this, the series, the TV wise. I own like 3 books, I believe. Still trying to get a hold of my hands on a bunch of other books, but still love the show. And that's it. We're back at the beginning on Your Favorite Dark. Now, let me know in the comments below if you've seen any of these shows, own any of these shows, and anything else, okay? And don't forget to subscribe, and comment. Until next time, peace. Okay, I'm trying to stop this thing. Okay, stop.